It was a strong night for Florida Republicans as Governor Ron DeSantis and Senator Marco Rubio both kept their seats in office.
Xavier Walton live in Miami with more on this. Xavier?
Adrian, Mitch, both races were called almost immediately after the polls closed here in Florida. You know, the Republicans, they came in confident. Democrats knew they had work to do on Election Day, and their concerns were valid. In the race for governor, the gubernatorial race, incumbent Governor Ron DeSantis defeating his Democratic opponent, former Florida Governor Charlie Crist. DeSantis, you see it here, getting more than 59% of the vote to Charlie Crist, 39%, nearly 40, wasn't really close. Here's both candidates after the race was called just last night.
Only one election, we have rewritten the political map. Thank you for honoring us with a win for the ages.
First and foremost, I want to give a good congratulations to Governor DeSantis on his reelection. That's okay. It's been an absolute blessing to serve as your governor before, to serve as the congressman from my hometown. I feel like the most blessed man ever.
So in the Senate race, Senator Marco Rubio was elected to his third term after defeating his Democratic opponent, Congressman Val Demings. This despite Demings' campaign, you know, outraising and outspending Rubio's team. They fell behind early and never made up the ground. The senior senator from Florida winning his third election for the U.S. Senate since 2010. And it appears, you know, Florida has shifted from a swing state to a solid red state with DeSantis and Rubio right there at the top.
Xavier Walton for us. Thank you so much.
Hey, thank you for watching. Please go to NewsNationNow.com, NewsNationNow.com, and you can find News Nation on your television provider. And don't forget to click the red subscribe button down below. Then you will get more of News Nation's fact-driven coverage.